Sorry, I had to talk in Hindi language because most of the people are here Indians. Some of them are Marathis and others are from the North India. I was telling them about Christ. What was His power? His power was of love and not of anger, because He is the one who has crossed the most difficult center of Agya. Those people who have ego never realize they have ego. With their ego, they do all kinds of nonsensical things. Without asking me, they have done something in Delhi. Without asking me, they have done something in Russia. And it's so destructive to Sahaja Yoga that they don't realize what they have done is a crime which is punishable by all divine laws. If you want to do anything, you must tell me beforehand. You must consult me. You must talk to me, because I know what is happening. You don't know. If somebody wants to cheat you, then how will you know? If you were so sensitive, you would find out. You would have asked me, Mother, what should we do? At least ask me. This is the main thing missing among Sahaja Yogis now, that we have a kind of a very subtle ego. If you make somebody a leader, it's very dangerous sometimes if the leader develops ego because of his wife. It's a very difficult thing. They can destroy Sahaja Yoga completely. Anything is possible. So before you do anything like that, you have to consult. I am still living and you can ask me. You can write to me, you can telephone to me. At least I am there to tell you. But then you have to develop your balance and your love. That is only through this Paramachaitanya. With this all-pervading power of divine love, you can develop that discretion, you can develop that special powers. Even if somebody telephones to me, immediately I know what's wrong with the person. I don't say that you can't become like me. But at least you have vibrations to see. Also see your own vibrations. How are you moving? Put a paper on your hand and you'll see it will start shaking before my photograph. With this ego, you cannot go further. Why did you come to Sahaja Yoga? You came here not to become some sort of a leader or some sort of a king, but you came here to become a great guru. As you asked me, Guru Pada Dijiye. For that you have to have in Sahaja Yoga a complete humility, natural humility, natural balance. This is what Christ has taught us. At that time, I don't think people had that much ego. Ego is a modern present to you. People get ego out of anything. For example, I met one lady once and found her ego very bad. I said, what's the matter with her? So I asked my daughters, what does she do? They said, Mummy, she knows how to make dolls. For that she had ego. What is so great than to be a good Sahaja Yoga? You may be the king, you may be anything. Now you see the prime ministers and all of them going to jail. What are they compared to you? They have no balance. They have no sense. What makes you a separate individuals, higher people? Because you have no ego. Now people try to remove their ego. There are two types. So they will go on beating themselves with shoes. All kinds of ritualistic things they do to remove their ego. But all this you do with your mind. Whatever you do with your mind will give you ego only. They become ascetic. They are the greatest egoist. I must say, Hitler was the greatest ascetic. With his asceticism he became Hitler. If you want to become Hitler, you become ascetic. In Sahaja Yoga you are not allowed at all this asceticism. You have to be loving, affectionate, kind and disciplined. I must say this because when you are loving, you go out of bounds sometimes because you have no discipline of Sahaja Yoga. Loving doesn't mean that you become like a Romeo Juliet, doesn't mean that. You must have your balance through your discipline. If you have no discipline, you can never be a good Sahaja Yoga. From the life of Christ, we have to learn these things, that unless and until we have these things, we cannot become good Sahaja Yogis. Firstly, ritualistic nature. Secondly, anger. Thirdly, miserliness. Like, if you go to England, it's written there, save pounds by taking a taxi. This is what it is, miserliness. Where can we save money? Mother, can you give concession? It's not some sort of a business I'm doing here. If you make it half price, so many will come. I'm not using your money. I'm using it for your buildings. All this, I've got it. Of course, my money also, and your money. So many things I've done. The whole of Vashi, the whole of ashram in Delhi, two ashrams, then the whole of school, and also land in Pune and other places. Now in Pune they want me to pay the land, to pay for everything, and Pune people are the known Maharashtrians to be great miserly kanjush people. Even for their own ashram, they would like me to pay for everything. And they nicely go and sing bhajans nicely. See, they are good musicians, that's what they are. But very, very miserly people. Miserly people can never love. They love money. Egoistical people can never love because they love power to control others. They think they are doing it for Sahaja Yoga, but not. Unless until you do something for yourself and your ego, no use working for Sahaja Yoga. Look at Christ. He took birth in a very humble abode. But he was the king. And he lived with the poor. And tried to save them. He saved the lepers, he saved so many people. There were 21 people were cured by him. Now Sahaja Yoga, I don't know how many thousands have been cured. But what is important is, if you are curing, you know that you are not curing. It is the divine power that is curing. You are not doing anything. It's best to be like that. I feel the same way, I am doing nothing, and I am nishkriya, doing anything. But I am not lazy. You should be active, but all your activity should come from the divine power of love. First of all, you must extend your hands for love. You extend your heart, extend your money, house, everything for love. Now if your wife doesn't allow others to come in the house, throw her out of the house, I don't mind. Teach her how to be kind and generous, the other way round for the husband. It's very important. You have to be generous, you have to be kind, you have to be loving and sweet to others. Christ only once went into temple, which he had a right to do that, when he saw people selling things in the temple. Same thing we have here. And if you don't go and buy anything from them, they'll be lost. But you only go and buy things from them because you have a habit of shopping. Anywhere the people go, they must shop. It's a habit. Shopping they must do. They will not see the greenery, the beauty of nature, nothing. When I went to so many countries, you see, I had to, with my husband, I had to go and see beautiful places like museums. I never used to shop. But when I have so many children, then I have to shop. So I would go for shops. But not the way that every place is for shopping. What is there to shop here when you have come here for your spiritual growth? In Mecca, do they have any shops? This is the holier than holy. Why should you go to these shops? I can't understand. I've told them not to have shops, but you people are the ones who encourage. Who encourage them to make money out of us? Nothing essential to buy there. Now you have come to the holy occasion. Here you have come for your worship. In our Mahalakshmi temple, there are people who are selling garlands and things for the ladies here. But they say it is for the goddess. And they buy there, all the people who are coming stupidly, and give it to the Brahmin in the temple. And the Brahmin sells it back at a lower price. And these garlands are, I don't know how many times, sold and bought and sold and bought because of the stupidity of the people who go there. If they have to take something, they should buy from outside. Not at the place where you have come. As it is, you went to Delhi, you could have bought there. Or you came to Bombay, you could have bought there. But not in this place. We cannot make this place Bombay or Delhi. Otherwise, why should we come here? That's why Christ took a hunter and beat them, those who were selling things near the church. Now they don't have. I've seen near the church they don't have. They have outside. But they sell other things. Like Catholic Church sells a wine called Benedictine. Imagine. That's another story. Christ went for a wedding and they had no wine. Now in the Hebrew language, wine means the juice of the grapes. It doesn't mean fermented. So he converted water into that wine. You cannot convert water instantaneously into wine. Wine has to rot, has to smell. The more it smells, the best it is. But they think that Christ said, you must drink, they say. He never said that. He just converted it into wine, meaning the taste of the juice of grapes. Once I went to some television and there was a very nice man in Italy. He said, Mother, you first give me realization. So I said, get some water, put my hand into it. Now you drink it. He said, it is tasting like wine. I said, this is what Christ did. He got his realization. Instantaneously you cannot make wine. But if somebody dies, they will drink. If somebody is born, they will drink. At any cost, without drinking, they are not normal. But the people who got realization have suddenly changed. They don't want to drink. They have stopped drinking. Their attention has become nice. The whole thing is changed. This is the transformation that has worked, of which Christ has talked, Muhammad Sahib has talked, everybody has talked about this particular time when people will get transformed. But even after transformation, you do not want to become what you have to be, for which you have come here. You will be left behind. There's a big transformation is taking place. In that transformation also your rising is taking place. There's a big evolution going on. And those who will not evolve properly will be left behind. As it is said that this is the last judgment. And you will be judged. You will be left behind. You cannot adhere to people who are rising higher. With your weight you will fall down. So, for you to understand Christ is all these qualities you must have. If you are hot-tempered, all right, go and beat yourself with shoes. But if you are not, then you need not. You must know what you are. First of all, introspect. Accordingly, you should work it out. But this ritualism is not allowed in Sahaja Yoga all the time. I would love all my children to be extremely loving and collective. Not to denounce anybody, for no rhyme and reason. And if you have to denounce, you should tell me. I know what is what. Without asking me, you should not measure up somebody and say, I have measured somebody. With what? What is your yardstick? You yourself, you are caught up in the web of ego. You cannot condemn anyone without telling me. You have to tell me. Don't worry that this will disturb me or anything, but you should ask me. I know about everyone. Maybe I have not met that person, but I can feel the vibration. You can write to me. Many people just telephone. That's not the way. You must write to me, because I read each and every letter. But all nonsensical letters you shouldn't write also to waste my time. Like my fathers, mothers, mothers, this thing is sick or is dead and her bhoot is moving about. All sorts of funny letters come to me. What can I do for such people? That's not important. Or I need money, I have no money, I am depending on you for money, so please send me money. You can ask on my photograph. If you are a good Sahajogi, you don't have to worry about money also. Or, I have no child, mother, what to do, I want to have child. Those who have child, ask them what do they have to say. So many have got children after coming to Sahajoga, but you must deserve it. So many miracles have taken place, so many people have been cured, no doubt. But that doesn't mean you have done it. Don't get into the trap of ego. That's most dangerous. If you destroy Sahajoga, you are destroying yourself. So, today you all have to promise in your heart, put your hands to your heart and to say, Mother, will love, will spread your divine love, encompass the whole world, give realization to all the people, will not shout, will not be angry, will not do the all kinds of rituals, but just surrender. Surrender our ego to you. Surrender it. Surrender your ego. All your problems can be solved. Because as long as there is ego, this divine power doesn't take over. You may do anything. You are not connected. Your connection is missing. Christ is missing. He is no more there. To establish Him, first of all, you must show how you love. That doesn't mean that you love your wife, love your children and love your house. You have to love everyone. Try to make everyone happy. That's why I like music, because through music you can spread vibrations. It's a very good media of spreading vibrations, of loving vibrations. But those who are musicians have to be loving people. Not hot-tempered, not showing off, not thinking too much of themselves. All this will work very well if you understand that this divine power is so powerful. No doubt it is love. No doubt it is truth. Oh, no doubt. If you get out of it, you will be caught up by anything and you could be finished. It is a very, very powerful, effective and absolutely conclusive power you have within yourself. And thanks to Christ that crucified Himself, sacrificed His body for our sake, that our agya is opened, otherwise I could not have done this sajoga. But in this area, we have Buddha, Christ and Mahavira. And they had to do tapasya, tapaha. They did it. You don't have to do now, they have done for you. Now see, I saw the musicians yesterday. In 2-3 months they have learned so much. Otherwise, formerly all the musicians I knew for Indian music had to really start. For months together they had to practice, years together they had to bow to their guru. That's all over now. Because of this Param Chaitanya. And your power to be one with the Divine. This Divine power can transform you completely to such an extent that anything that you want to do, you can do it in 2-3 months. In Pune, when they were singing once, foreigners, as we call them, with respect. In India, foreigners means respect, not like other countries. So they were singing, there were some very great musicians had come. And they told me, Mother, we put down our head to them. Because how could these people, who don't know a word about Indian music, have learnt it so well, and the pronunciation of this Marathi language is very difficult, but they are so good at it. It's very surprising. Now all this has happened in your presence. In your presence. It's nice you have balloons here to celebrate Christ's birthday, and all these balloons in your head of ego should be burst, should be finished. But I'll be happy if you could learn Hindi language. Well, I know English may not be so good, but best is to learn Hindi, if possible. Because there are already 14 languages in India and so many languages in another country. Every country has a different type of English language. If you go to America, I don't understand their English for at least 2-3 days. Because they go on taking their tongue and the lips on one side, then on another side. English of the French is another point. So best is to learn Hindi, and that too a good Hindi. Not Sanskritized, but as they say, rozmarrake, day to day Hindi, because I feel better if you all understand what I am saying. It's not difficult because you are all sahajogis, you can learn Hindi in no time. I am not saying learn Sanskrit, but Hindi is very easy. Try to, it's not my mother tongue. I have never studied Hindi language, never. But, you see, it's a very easy language to learn. But, as my father told me, never teach Hindi language to an Englishman. I said, why this advice? He said, there was an Englishman who was after me that I should teach him Hindi. So he said, I have to tell my servant to open the door or to close the door. So for open the door, he said, you say, there was a cold day, means darwaza khol de. And for closing the door, you have to say, there was a banker. Mane darwaza band kar. But now it's different. They'll pick up Hindi very quickly. Very quickly, I can see that. If they can learn this horrible Indian classical music, which is so difficult, so easily, what will happen? They can learn Hindi in no time and make me happier with that. Not because Hindi is my language, it's not, it's Marathi. But Marathi is very difficult, I don't think you can learn Marathi. It's very precise. I think that is one of the best languages to put down your ego. That's why Maharashtrians are normally not egoistical, because in their language there is built-in process. For example, somebody is boasting that I've done this, I've done that. So in Marathi they will say, don't climb on a bush or what we call the tree of chana, which is so big as that. Then the person is finished. Like that there are many words by which you can put down the ego of the man on his face. So Marathi language has so many advantages. But I would not ask you to learn Marathi language, it's not so easy. But Hindi you should, it is very easy, very easy. But you must know one thing, that in Hindi language there is adab. Adab means modesty and
respect,
but more than respect, a style of saying things. Not Urdu, but Hindi of day-to-day talking. There is respect and a way to address others. To address others. All this will give you a kind of a more flexible vehicle to express your love. Because in Hindi language, we can never translate, I hate you. We never say like that. I hate you. मैं आपसे घृणा करता हूँ, ऐसे कोई कहेगा क्या? They cannot say, to hate somebody is sinful. So they can never say, I hate you. Chastity is more in Marathi language, but it's a little hard, because it has got such, as I told you, idioms which can correct you just there. All this is just to request you now, if you can learn this music, which is very difficult, you can always learn a simple Hindi language, which is very, very easy and very, very easy to talk. There are so many things I would like you to know about Christ, but this is short time in which I cannot tell you. The way he had his own priorities. Though in the Bible he is not described fully, I should say, and whatever it might have been, they have reduced it, maybe. And the way they practice Christianity also is shocking. So one has to learn Christianity through the heart, no other way out. They should learn through the heart, heart of your mother. May God bless you.